Hello, everyone. This is Rev Paul with Miracles One, and welcome to another episode of Insights on A Course in Miracles. Over the last week, we worked on lessons 346 through 352. And within that group of lessons, there was also the last What Is reading, which was number 14, What Am I? And when we take a look at the very first paragraph of What Am I, notice that it's in italics. And that is, when we see italics within A Course in Miracles, it's usually a prayer. It is a prayer. And if you take a look at this reading, it's that first paragraph is in italics, and it's a prayer that we are praying to God. And in this one, it's interesting because it's more of a declaration that we finally are coming to a place of accepting who we really are, as we have been taught by A Course in Miracles and Jesus and the Holy Spirit over the last year as we worked on this mind training program in the workbook for students. So I want to read that paragraph here. So our declaration is, I am God's son, complete and healed and whole, shining in the reflection of his love. So we are all declaring that we are God's sons and daughters. And he's talking about the spiritual part of us when we say this. We're not talking about the physical body. The next sentence declares, in me is his creation, sanctified and guaranteed eternal life. I find that guarantee of eternal life to be personally comforting. Because most of my life, I've struggled with feeling unsafe for a variety of reasons and things that I experienced going all the way back to my childhood. In me is perfect love. No, wait. In me is love perfected, fear impossible, and joy established without opposite. I am the holy home of God himself. I am the heaven where his love resides. I am his holy sinlessness itself. For in my purity abides his own. There's a lot of wonderful phrases in there. I like fear is impossible, joy is established without opposite, and that I am the holy home of God himself. And that is completely different from what I was raised to believe about myself. I think most of us have been raised with belief systems that indicate that we're not perfect, we're sinful people, we're sinful beings, and Jesus has been telling us time and time again throughout A Course in Miracles and these lessons that it's not true. All of these beliefs and perceptions that we have about ourselves is just a dream, it's just an illusion, and it's not true. And what I really like about A Course in Miracles is not only does he describe those kind of ideas to us, he gives us a way to begin to learn how to begin to personally experience these statements of truth. It's not that we have to take his word for it or some text in a book. That we have to take that word for it. We have been provided with instructions on how to open up our minds to the Holy Spirit within us to begin to hear his voice. And he is the voice for God. He's the mediator. He's the messenger between God and us in getting messages from God to us through the illusion. He also helps us with seeing ourselves in the world through Christ's vision, through the eyes of Christ, which he indicates later here in a later paragraph. Ours are the eyes through which Christ's vision sees a world redeemed from every thought of sin. Ours are the ears that hear the voice for God proclaim the world is sinless. And he's talking about these miracle experiences of being able to see the light in ourselves and in one another and in the world around us through the gift of Christ's vision, which can happen little moments of holy miracles and instance. And then we can also hear this inner voice of the Holy Spirit speak to us. And you can hear that in an audible voice. You can hear it in an unaudible voice. But when it does happen, you'll know it without a doubt. And he says here in paragraph 3 too, that we are the bringers of salvation. We accept our part as saviors of the world, which through our joint forgiveness is redeemed. And our gift is therefore given us. So as we've been working on these lessons throughout the year and learning how to forgive all of the untruthful things about what's going on around us and what's going on with this within us, when we allow forgiveness to continue to work through us and let go, we become more relaxed, we become more open. And when that happens, the miracles of light start to come through, and we begin to perceive those more frequently. The miracle of hearing the voice of God speak to us starts to happen more frequently, and they begin to happen together. We've been moving and practicing, you know, at the beginning of the lessons, we moved, you know, he had us working on just letting go and considering other ideas that were, you know, letting go of untruthful things and opening up to some new ideas that are around what's really is going on. And then he moves us into learning how to see the light of God within us. And he also has other lessons that help us to go within, be very still, and listen for the voice of God to speak to us. And with enough time and practice and effort and meditation practice of listening and being open to seeing, that light starts to eventually to flash through in little flashes and reveal itself. That is the beginning of Christ's vision. We also begin to have experiences of hearing the voice. So we start to become aware that these things that he's been talking about are really true, that they're there and we can experience them for ourselves. But it's also moving us into a direction of becoming true miracle workers within the world. And that's what we're here to do. Not only to help ourselves to awaken, we are also here to be facilitators for the Holy Spirit, to be miracle workers for Jesus and the Holy Spirit within the illusion, to help others who are still suffering, who are still caught in the illusion of fear and anxiety and depression and misery. And they have no idea that there's a way out. That's as we have learned how to open up to the miracle of light and love inside of us and become aware of it. We know it's there. And the miracle of hearing the voice of the Holy Spirit guiding us to help us with our own lives, he will also begin to guide us to reach out and help others in their lives. And if you really want to experience the miracle of Christmas this year, I would invite you to consider trying it that way, trying to go within Holy Spirit, go within meditation and asking the Holy Spirit, say, hey, today I would like to learn how to perform a miracle. Show me, what is that like? How do we do that? How can I be a miracle worker here? I was working on that last week with the Holy Spirit and with Jesus, and I was asking them, how do I perform miracles here? Can you give me, you know, help me to do that? I want to see what that's like. Start teaching me how to do that. And what happened, I didn't, and it was kind of unexpected because I had been asking for a couple days, but on the second or the third day in my meditation, I got a vision of someone that I knew who passed away a year ago. And I did the memorial service for the individual. He was one of our wonderful study group members, and he suddenly got a brain tumor. And a couple months later, he had passed away from it. And I started to get visions of him from the other side unexpectedly. And I took that as, when I reflected on it, I was like, why am I getting these? Why is he reaching out to me? Why am I getting these visions? And I felt prompted or guided to reach out to his son and to his son's wife. And so I did. And I reached out, got a voicemail, voicemail greeting, and I left a message, and we didn't connect on that day. The next day, when I was in meditation again, I got the vision again from this individual that had passed away a year ago from the other side, and he was looking happy and healthy and everything was good. But I took it, I want you to reach out to my son and to my daughter-in-law. And so I did. I reached out on the second day, and we eventually caught up with each other, and we really had a nice conversation. And through the course of the conversation, I learned that they, they were still grieving the loss of this father and loved one that was so, wonderful in their lives, this wonderful human being. And I, through the course of reconnecting a little bit, I shared with them. I said, hey, I want you to know that he's still doing well. He's still doing okay, because I unexpectedly got these visions from him, and he's happy and he's well. And I that's what prompted me to reach out to you guys. And I trust that they found that to be comforting. And I see that as, in hindsight, that's one of the ways that, because I've learned how to go within and open up to experience of Christ's vision and hearing the voice of the Holy Spirit and hearing Jesus talking to me and prompting me and helping me with things, that now that is an example of how I can be a miracle worker within the world. Because they know what's going on. They know what the big picture is. They know who needs help. I don't. And they know what the big plan of awakening is, the great awakening, and how we're all going to be awakened from this. We have a part in this plan of great awakening. And however, we have to be willing to say, all right, I'm here. How are you good? I want to do this. I want to be a miracle worker. I've been studying A Course in Miracles for a long time. Show me how to do this. I want to be a part of it. And they'll help you to do that. Now think about that for your Christmas miracle this year. To totally, unplug that Christmas machine and take it to a whole new level with the help of the Holy Spirit, with the help of Jesus, and the hard work that you've been doing all year long in A Course in Miracles. And you'll notice that when you're working on these last lessons, it's just all about going within and being silent and open and ready and waiting in expectation for him to show you these visions from the vision of Christ, and for him to show you or talk to you through that, the voice of God, right? Once that stuff starts happening, it's a huge game changer for your life and everyone's life potentially around you, because you have truly learned to take the beginning steps of being a miracle worker. What a wonderful Christmas gift you gave to yourself this year. So I wish all of you a very Merry Christmas. I love you all very much, and we'll see you again real soon. Bye-bye.
For more A Course in Miracles video teachings, our study groups, podcasts, self-study courses, articles, and personal A Course in Miracles coaching, access our website at miraclesone.org.